At Ubuntu Summit 2024, System 76 held a talk on the Cosmic Desktop. Now, the Carl section is a really good listen, but it's a lot of stuff that we've already covered before in prior videos. What Cosmic's about, how to use it, what their general goals are, the tiling and the floating stuff, and if you've not heard anything about that, go check that out, go watch my prior videos, or go and check out my streams where things tend to break really, really badly, especially, the latest stream. The latest stream was kind of a mess. But instead of talking about that section, I want to talk about Victoria Breckenfield's section, who you may know online as Draculix. She's kind of the brains behind the Smithy Compositor Library, the library being used for the Cosmic Compositor, and she's been working on this long before being employed at System 76. Also, I don't know what her official title is, but she's also kind of the brains behind the compositor component of the Cosmic Desktop, the Cosmic Compositor, which is a very, how would we say, creative name. Now, take note of the fact that I said component. That is a very important term and wasn't just chosen randomly. The goal of Smithy, and also now the goals of the Cosmic Compositor, is to make a modular, compatible, and composable system. So a system that you can take apart and you can put in new modules, a system that is compatible with Wayland standards, and a system that is also composable, as in you can take these different pieces and arrange them in different ways. Now, from the very start, Carl and everybody else involved has been saying that Cosmic is supposed to be a modular system. It's supposed to be something that distro developers can take and then sort of brand it in their own way, modify the Cosmic Desktop so it's not just the same thing everywhere, right? Like, the thing they show off with Cosmic is the way they are branding it for PopOS. Their users come from a GNOME plus PopShell background, so they're going to make it like that experience, but that is not the way it's supposed to be for every single user. Obviously, they bring up things like, oh, you can have multiple panels and things like that. But that's only scratching the surface of what you can really do with Cosmic. Now, to support these goals, when it comes to Wayland protocols, Cosmic relies on as many upstream protocols and public APIs as just makes sense to do. It tries to limit the amount of Cosmic-only things it's doing. Now, Cosmic does have a repo called Cosmic Protocols, but if you know anything about Wayland protocols, you might notice that a lot of these seem really familiar. Things like image source, things like screen copy. A lot of these are protocols that exist in the upstream repo, but are still in active development, haven't yet been merged, but Cosmic wants to go and make use of it on their side, or they're using this repo as a way to go and test it in Cosmic, and then try to get those changes upstreamed into the Wayland repo. The goal here is the protocols that they are using, they want everyone else to be using, because that makes it a lot easier to go and collaborate on software that exists outside their desktop. In the same vein, there shouldn't be any of these private, internal, undocumented APIs, except in cases where it only makes sense to do it in that way. There shouldn't be a situation where there is an accepted solution that other desktops are adopting, and because your desktop doesn't, people feel the need to try and write software that relies on that internal API, but it's not really intended to be like that, so at some point in the future, you go and change how the API works, and it breaks all of the software that uses it. That just shouldn't be happening. With that being said, due to the early state of Cosmic, with it still being in an alpha, there are some things which are just not documented yet, which are intended to be documented in the future. Basic things like the way they handle workspace information, you know, the workspace number you're on, how many workspaces are available, that is being done with an internal protocol, but long term, as we get to the full release, that information is going to be a lot easier to get access to, and building tools that interact with it shouldn't be a problem. However, they are trying to upstream that protocol, so hopefully there'll just be a standard way of knowing how many workspaces exist on Wayland at some point in the future. Everything has workspaces, so hopefully we can agree on this basic thing. Now, thanks to Cosmic being designed from the start with this idea, rather than taking an existing project and then trying to adapt it into being this, this allows you to do, even in this fairly early state, as long as you're willing to write a bit of extra daemon code to glue everything together, some really weird and interesting things that I didn't realize were possible. Now, whilst it's possible, Victoria does admit that, you know, the Cosmic team did put a lot of effort into the Cosmic Compositor, so they would like you to use the Cosmic Compositor. So I think it's best to let Victoria explain this demo.
Completely different. And we are right back into Cosmic, or should I say Cosway or whatever, because this is, of course, not Cosmic. This is Sway running all the Cosmic components with almost no modifications. I think I wrote about 80 lines or something to get this working on the track.
So basically what we have here is the Cosmic panel, the Cosmic launcher, all of that sort of stuff, that is being used with the compositor part not being the Cosmic compositor, instead being the Sway compositor. And the reason this works is when it comes to the Cosmic lock screen or the Cosmic launcher or the Cosmic panel, all of this stuff is just using standard Wayland protocols that exist in Sway as well. Now, they don't have all of the same protocols, but as things get better, there's going to be more coverage of what is available in these other compositors, and you can just do this. And with a bit of glue code, you can do things like this.
You can go into appearance setting. Now, I could, of course, change the accent color, but that wouldn't really translate over to Sway. But of course it does, because I wrote a little daemon. So your accent colors get synced into the Sway configuration, and everything just seamlessly adopts. And now you can use Sway with Cosmic.
And doing that with basically any other compositor realistically isn't that difficult. It's just a bit of extra code. You just listen to changes that happen in Cosmic, and then most compositors have some sort of like IPC system. You just update things there and you're pretty much good to go. And whilst this is neat, Sway frankly is kind of boring, right? Because Cosmic has tiling. Yes, Sway tiling is manual tiling, but it's still tiling. What if you could do something else?
We get a bunch of requests for, what about if we had scrolling tiling on Cosmic? And you know, for our UX developers, I imagine this is not a nice question, because they spent so much time in building out a good tiling UX, and now suddenly you should have a whole different tiling paradigm. How do you explain this to users? How do you make it easy to switch between these things? But I say, let the designers figure this out. Maybe we'll support scrolling tiling at some point in version 4. Maybe we won't. No idea yet. But if you want scrolling tiling in the meantime, just use Neary. Neary is a perfectly fine project, also built on Smithy. I like it a lot. And then you suddenly have scrolling tiling working just fine on Cosmic. Mostly fine, I should say, because if you have a scale larger than one, then somehow the panel breaks.
Alpha software. Alpha, that's all I can say. Alpha software does alpha things. But this is not like a fundamental problem with the model. This is a little bug, and bugs can be dealt with. The fact that this mostly works just as is, and there's not really that much extra work that's done to make this happen, that's really cool. But this is Ubuntu Summit, so you can't exactly just show off Smithy stuff, because that's her own project. We gotta see something else.
I need to run this on Mir.
This one's a bit more broken.
Sore throat from an infection some weeks ago. And now this is Cosmic running on Mir. Unfortunately, the background daemon doesn't quite work, because Miracle, at least in the version that ships on Fedora, for some reason doesn't even support the viewporter protocol.
Again, just a bug.
Sorry, somebody of you will maybe have to fix this. Also, pop-ups on Layer Shell clients seem to be very interesting. As soon as I interact with this, the panel just crashes.
But again, that's just all bugs, right? Actually, you didn't even see that. The panel in the bottom corner here, go back a little bit, right here.
Very interesting. As soon as I interact with this, the panel...
Just a bug, right? Like, not a fundamental core issue. It's, you're using alpha software in a non-standard way, in a kind of non-supported way, but it mostly just works. And I know some of you are going to ask, can I go and run this? Yes, this is not officially supported. It's probably gonna break. Just keep in mind, this is very early stuff on an alpha project, but it is here. And also, since some of you might want to know, yes, you could probably use KWin as the compositor as well. In the same vein, with a bit of extra work, you could probably do it the other way around, using the Cosmic Compositor as the compositor under KDE. Or under Plasma. Is it going to work perfectly? Absolutely not. Will it probably work for the most part? Yes. Will you need to know how to write some glue code to just make settings actually function correctly? Oh, without a doubt. Now, this by itself is already really cool, but where this gets even cooler is when we start talking about modularity in other parts of the system. One example brought up here was in the Cosmic panel. Now, we all know that panels on every system, you can have applets, right? Like, KDE has this, GNOME has this, every desktop that has a panel has some sort of applet system. The Cosmic panel, though, is a little bit powerful. The fact that it just operates with little icons, that's just a convenient thing because that's the way most things in applet work. But this is just a nested Wayland compositor. The panel is a Wayland compositor itself. And applets are just standard XDG shell clients running in the compositor. They're just standard Wayland applications. Even though the desktop is written in Rust, and a lot of the developers on the team like Rust, you don't have to write applets in Rust. You can write an applet in any toolkit that supports Wayland, which is any toolkit you want to use under Linux. You can do normal things like have your system monitor. I know a lot of people like doing this, it's not really my thing. You can do stupid things like taking your i3 status output and just replacing the entire panel with an i3 bar. It is fully controllable. If you think you can do it, if you can write the code for it, it can probably be done with the panel. When they say you can replicate, you know, the Unity experience or the GNOME experience or the KDE experience, whilst what they have in the user-facing settings and the config files doesn't really seem to indicate that, if you start digging into the code, if you start writing custom modules, you have a lot of power in this system. Now, the problem is being alpha software, nothing is documented right now. So, actually doing so is a matter of taking what already exists and then adapting the code and guessing from there, pretty much. But you can do other stupid things, right? Remember, I said this is a nested Wayland compositor. You can literally take a game and then render a game in the panel. The example here was Celeste. But yes, you could do Doom if you want to write the code to make Doom run in the panel. Whilst I just like Cosmic for what it already is, obviously it has a lot of bugs, and if you've seen my recent streams, you've definitely seen me get involved in some of those bugs. Memory leak bugs and crash bugs and lots of fun bugs. Alpha software has alpha problems again. But I am so excited to see what people can build with this system once we actually have developer documentation and once the system is fully out with, you know, a full release. Because that's when things are really going to start happening. People are already writing applets and things like that, but when things are really going to get exciting is when it's accessible to everyone. When you have Fedora Cosmic and, I was going to say Kubuntu, but we already have that. Cosbuntu? We'll go Cosbuntu. When things like this are available and it's widely accessible, I think there's going to be a lot of really cool things made with Cosmic. But what do you guys think? Do you think people are actually going to care about this desktop? I know some people say, oh, it's like GNOME Lite. But knowing what you know now, do you think that's still the case? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, Libera Pay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I'm going to keep testing this out until we get beta and then full release, and that's probably when I'm going to switch to it.